still in his lecture, please. I've been working in the rain for about 30 years. The first decade of my activity was in the office of education. And this is an area, and also I love the food, probably noticed on my plate last night. And the second decade of my education and work was focused on research, where I got my PhD. And getting involved in the marine industry, and I worked on ships as an engineer officer for about 4 years in 2003. And in the last decade of my activities, obviously, we focused on certain areas of research. I'm working about ballast water, starting about 2001. So I've been working on this topic as one of the many other research work that we do in Newcastle, but this was my main focus. We have worked on it for about 10 years. The other point I would like to say is that, as much as for the matter of selfishness, I'm happy nobody has given any paper on this topic yet, which is good, because then I can claim I was the only one who presented this type of topic to the conference. But that is only for my selfishness, but I wish there were some other ones. And the other thing which I would like to say, I wish I had seen something more about marine engineering. Most of the presentation, most of colleagues are mainly focused on naval officers and topics and design ship structure. Of course, they are extremely important to my technology, but there are other aspects of ship design, there are other parts of this industry which are extremely important. And that is the part of college, probably the holistic view on the development of the system. But having said this, why did you choose this name, and how I'm going to go about this presentation? For me, ballast water management is a case study, and I would like to tell you how can we approach design of a shipyard, design of a ship, production of a ship, in a holistic manner, and what are the parameters we need to take into account. A ship is a combination of many different systems, and the ship in the chain of transport is one of the stakeholders of this business, and the business of marine technology is a multiple stakeholder environment, and that does not make life easy for the people who are working in that environment. It's like five people sleeping on one bed and having one blanket. Everybody would like to put the blanket on themselves, and they would like to look at it from their own point of view. So, divorcing from other parts of this industry is quite easy. It's quite easy that you just become focused on CFP and don't think about other things. And it is easy to only become focused on numerical analysis of some kind, or design of the hull, or design of the engine. It's quite easy to be able to ignore the other part of this business. So the way I'm trying to talk about this holistic view, for me, ballast water represents the case study, and then how this, as one of the most important challenges of the industry in the recent years, could be a good example for us. A little bit of introduction about ballast water is one of the major issues for environmental protection. IMO has been struggling during the last 10 years to be able to come up with a set of guidelines and a set of regulations which could be adopted by certain countries. And because of this multi-stakeholder nature of the business, a lot of political issues associated with it, there is no saga of ratification of the Arnhem-Valaskoza Convention, which was produced in February 2004. 6 years, still there's not enough countries that have signature and tonnage to be able to ratify the convention. I'm not sure whether Bangladesh has signed or not. But Bangladesh being a marine country and having a lot of coastline and probably a lot of aquaculture, the only line to be affected by the impact of not only ballast water, the environmental damage, but also by the regulations, the forthcoming regulations. So hopefully this presentation will set some of those priorities for you to see what is important to think about. Regulations are people call D1 and D2, and the whole thing, the whole issue with ballast water, if I could put it very briefly, then the ships take up the ballast water, they carry non-indigenous species, they are dangerous to the new environment, they damage factories, they block pipes, they kill local fish, so they damage livelihood of the fishermen, they damage the livelihood of people going to industries. And you are not exempted from it, and this is going to happen. It's not the only vector, there are other vectors, such as algae, if you have some papers about it. So this is the one we practically carry these species on board the ship and delivers them somewhere else quite nice and fresh. There are a lot of criteria which has been suggested and decided, and none of the guidelines and none of the things which has been put together discusses this matter in a way that addresses all the issues and all the challenges. This is not the IMO's job to do, I have to say. IMO is not there to tell us how to run the marine transportation system. IMO is there to protect certain things, same as class societies, the same as the port state authority. But each one of them has a certain job to do, and so does the ship owner and the ship operator. But whether there are contradictions within the regulations, that there are multiple problems which are associated with one element of this problem to the others, we need to see. This is what we are going to see, how this could affect the design of the system. In anything you want to do, if you want to design a shipyard, if you want to design a system, if you want to design a we are somewhere that we want to start, we understand the requirements for the need. This is what we call an engineering design. It is not relevant to the ships. It's relevant to any engineering system we want to put together. The next step is to look at the organizational structure, how the things are going to connect to each other, who's going to talk to whom, and which engineers we should try to put together. And then we look at the markets and targets, who are going to be the end users, who are going to buy my system, who's going to sell my system, who's going to operate my system, how much benefit I'm going to get. Then we create solutions. Some of the solutions have USP, which are unique selling points, whether the ship is in Bangladesh have a unique selling point, which they are the cheapest, or they are the best, or they are the cleanest. So these are the things you do, and then you go to evaluation, to technical assessments, different assessments, multiple criteria analysis, and then you send it for classification, whether it gets approved or not, to enter the market. And once it is entered into the market, and you start making money, or you originally close your company. That is what happens, and obviously all of this has to happen in a time scale which is appropriate for delivery. Why Korea became Korea? Because they reduced this timeline from there to there to a much shorter time. They had something yesterday. This is what engineering design looked like for anything we wanted to do, whether it's a large system or a small system. Internally, even in your organizational system manufacturing unit, you get the order, then you put together the technology group, and then they start looking into the mission profile of the ship and the design and sustainability of that particular design. Then you put the generic design, and then you look into verification plans, and then you put the specific and relevant regulations next to it, whether it comes from IMO, from ISO, or any other standards. Then you do the first round of design assessment and optimization, another peer review, you do the final design and dissemination of the design. So this is what happens inside a small design unit in a company. As far as chip design and chip system design are concerned, we can do it at three different levels. We can do it as a retrofit, if the system is going to go on board the ship. You can do it during the build, and you can design something which you can sell it off the ship, because it can be supplied. And whatever you do with these three, which you want to deliver a system to be manufactured for the application of the ships, on board the ships, you have to go through either of these routes. And to be able to do that, you have to take a lot of things into account. Whether this system you want to make, it has VOC associated to it, corrosion, leakage, emissions, ballast water, all the issues associated with the damage to the environment, damage to the ship, damage to the safety. Okay, this was all the things that we do as engineers. And then we take into account all these parameters. These are all the internal structures that we put together to be able to put the system together.